Hello, good morning, good afternoon. I'm Frédéric Fougat. I'm a filmmaker, and I love to film nature and to tell stories of nature, incredible stories. So I'm showing you today a film on a very special ecosystem, which is the ecosystem of the Alps. High mountains of the European Alps, which is a film that took me 2-3 years to make, and this is a very special, I think, a very special moment in my career, because doing this film, I realized that I had a wrong idea of nature in my mind. And probably an idea that is really shared by many people, and which is wrong. What is wrong is to consider that that the major forces in the ecosystems between living things is competition. It's not true. Competition is a very strong force. It's true. That's a fact, but in fact, it's not the only force, and there's another force, which is cooperation, and cooperation is even more important in certain places, and more important biologically because it's very creative. Why cooperation in the Alps? Because in fact, what scientists have discovered is that the poorest the area is, the less food there is, the less competition is effective. So when you live in an environment where there is not enough food, where it's cold, where everything is difficult, well, the only strategy that works is cooperating with others, being, you know, helping each others, because if you start competing when there's not enough, then everybody suffers from it, and it may work individually, but in the end it doesn't work. So that's what I learned doing this film, because in the Alps, really, the highest you go in the altitude, and the more you see that you know, birds cooperate to find food, plants cooperate to live for temperature, to live in an ecosystem. You know, wolves, they do cooperate very much. You know, they live in a society that is very collective, to find food, to you know, to protect their territory and all. So so definitely this this film, while doing it, I really focused on the stories that shows the most cooperative behavior into the nature of the Alps. So you will have stories of trees, stories of wolves, stories of birds, and also a very particular particular story of wolf, because I was very touched. You know, we know that in the Alps the wolves have disappeared in the 20th century, and there were only a few wolves left in Italy, and of course Romania, but further. But in the west part of Europe, there is, you know, maybe 10, 15, 50 wolves left, and in a very small region. And starting at the end of the 20th century until now, the wolf has expanded again. And that's quite extraordinary, because they had no help from humans, no help at all. They were not desired so far. And but they managed to grow and to conquer territory. Now we have maybe 10,000 wolves in Western Europe, which is a lot compared to what there was 30 years ago. So This story was very touching, and I decided to reenact the story of one particular wolf that was born in Italy, and that did a huge travel across the Alps, and that in the end founded a new family in France. So we took records of the trajectory of wolves. Because they were followed by colors, you know, so we took the records and we tried to build up the perfect trajectory of one wolf that went out of his group one day, and that made these 2,000 kilometers in order to establish and found a new family. And that's a very, very particular thing that all the wolves do. You know, when they live in a family and they are not at ease, they go away. And that is at the root of the expansion of wolves. So I think you will love this story. It's very touching. It's the story of a female who's actually the leading female of a group. But something happens to her. You'll see it's quite sad in the beginning, but it gets better on the way. So that's a beautiful story, and I think definitely what is in there in this film generally is another idea, another vision of nature that is not communicated that much, because it's always competition. No, we're talking about cooperation. This force of cooperation is really amazing, and that's not what we were told in school. You know, we were taught that competition was the real force, and I think cooperation deserved to be known better, and for us it's important to know that in life it's not only competing that is important. You know, cooperating is more important, you know. So I think there's a great knowledge and great, it's very wise. What life says to us in the Alps is very wise. And we have to take that back home and take us for us. So it did make me stronger, I think, to realize that I didn't have to compete that much. So hope you'll understand that and feel that, because it's important to feel, and that you'll enjoy the show. So have a good show, have a good evening, and bye bye. Thank you.